Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to add backgrounds to PDFs in Adobe Acrobat. Specifically, we'll look at how to add background colors and background images, and how to customize both of those options. I'll be using Adobe Acrobat Pro with the new interface introduced in 2023. However, we'll include the steps for the previous interface when necessary. In addition, these steps are the same for PC and Mac users. These steps don't apply to Adobe's free PDF display software, Acrobat Reader. To begin adding a background, first open the PDF and then select All Tools in the toolbar. When the Tools menu opens, select Edit a PDF, followed by the More link. From there, select Background and Add. If you're using an older version of Acrobat, select the Tools tab, followed by Edit PDF in the Tools Center. Next, select More in the Edit PDF toolbar, followed by Background and Add. When the Add Background dialog box appears, select From Color if you want to add a background color. Then select the Color Picker and choose a color from the drop-down menu. To add a custom color, select Other Color and then select a color in the Color dialog display, or add color values into the text boxes, and select the OK button. Today I'm going to add a background image instead of a color. It's important to note that you can only add a background color or an image, not both. To add an image, select File, followed by the Browse button. Then locate and select the image from the open dialog box. You can choose another PDF, a JPEG, or a bitmap file, and then select the Open button. Now you can use the Appearance and Position options to customize the background. For example, you can rotate the image or color block, change the opacity, adjust the scale, and change the position from the center, top, or bottom. You can also select the Appearance Options link to change the printing and display on-screen options. If you want to add the background to specific pages, select the Page Range Options link, and then select Pages From, and enter a page range into the text boxes. The subset menu provides additional options to include the background on all pages in range, even pages only, or odd pages only. Today I'm going to include my background on all pages. After making your choice, select the OK button. If you want to add the same background to other PDFs, select Apply to Multiple Files. However, carefully review those PDFs afterwards because the process may produce unexpected results if those PDFs don't have the same number of pages or formatting as the current PDF. Lastly, select the OK button. Your new background should now appear in your PDF. Note that if you want to update or delete the background later on, you can return to the Background drop-down menu and then select Update or Remove, and then follow prompts in the associated dialog boxes. And as always, remember to save your PDF to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Adobe Acrobat, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to combine PDFs into one in Adobe Acrobat Pro. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.